I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
What's up, Benny?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good, what's up?
Yeah, but yeah, even in this.
It's a packed house, hundreds and hundreds of fans that showed up here.
Yes.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we go down to our next fight, the 10-round heavyweight special attraction. We have our partners, five pounds.
Anything to tell Danny Garcia?
Huh?
Anything to tell Danny Garcia?
No, not right now. You know what it is.
Ellie!
Go for it, man.
He's sitting on it right now.
Good job. Good job, man. Got a little heated up there. Hey, but the fans were calling your name. Mucho fanáticos.
Mucho, mucho bueno.
Feliz, they were happy.
Yeah.
That was cool. How you feeling? Tony, do you even watch the Wayne, or are you on your phone the whole time?
I watch it, actually. I videoed it as much as I could. I wanted to see there. He was saying some stuff. What was Easter saying? I couldn't obviously.
I don't know. What was he saying?
What was he saying, Mike? Easter. Same old bullshit. Little pal.
Mikey, you got right on Wayne.
We took care of the weight, professional, now we're going to focus on the fight. How would you like to do it?
So Robert, what were you guys saying when you were facing off? The whole house went crazy.
To get in shape.
And what did he, why did you say that?
Look at his body, man. Y'all gonna see, man. July 28th, y'all about to see, man.
Did he answer you?
No, he didn't answer me. He couldn't talk. He hurt already. Come on, man. Y'all seen that.
Was this the most lit Wayne you've been part of? The energy?
Of course.
He was lit. A big crowd.
Gonna be even more lit fight night.
What do you tell all your fans back home who are excited who couldn't make it to California? You're gonna watch on Showtime.
If you believe in me, keep believing in me. Cause you know I'm not gonna never disappoint you. We gonna come with this two belts, victorious, all that, man. I'm telling you, man. Listen, I don't lie.
What makes Kevin Cunningham such a great trainer?
His record speaks for itself. He's a 12-time world champion.
Hey, very serious. No jokes. It's boot camp. No, what Adrian called it, a 5-star jail.
It's all to keep you focused.
And it's working. I saw it. I was watching on your IG. You put up notes. What's going to happen? You're very focused.
Yeah.
Is that something you came up with or so you saw it somewhere? Thanks. This one? This one. Is that something that you came up on your own? Or
yeah, it's something new that I read upon, you know. Just writing down your goals, man. Speaking them into existence. You know, I'm a firm believer in that. You know, and that's... You gotta stay focused on your goal. Every day I roll over and I wake up, I see a note. You know what I'm saying? It motivates me even more. This is what I'm working for each day. You feel me? Every day I work up and train even harder, you know, looking at these notes, man.
Where do you get this confidence from?
Myself. You gotta get it from yourself.
Nothing can stop you. Nothing can stop. Tunnel vision.
Tunnel vision.
Have you always been like that? First grade, fifth grade, high school?
Any goal I had, any goal I had, I worked hard to achieve it, and, you know, make it to meet my goal at everything. So
for the millions around the world that are going to tune into the fight, and if they haven't seen you before, what would they see in Robert Easter Jr.?
You said what?
For the people who haven't had a chance really to know you as a fighter, what will they see tomorrow?
Oh, they going, I'm gain a lot of new fans tomorrow. You know, they going to see from my heart. You know, my skill that I put in this, everything, you know, everything. They gonna be like, this is what we've been missing. You know, what Robert Easter is bringing to the table, man. And I'm just ready to show to everybody. I'm tired of talking about it. I've been training for months. I miss my son. I ain't seen my son in 2 months. I'm tired of the talk. I'm just trying to get this fight over with.
Unofficially, they announced this fight about 3 months ago. Officially, it was like 6 weeks. So you already knew you're fighting someone. I don't know if you knew if it was Mikey, but you started training super early.
I trained super early because of the adjustments me and Coach Cunningham had to make. You know, me and Coach Cunningham. So that's why I had to go early to get a feel of Coach Cunningham and his program, because I knew it was going to be different. So I wanted to be in shape when we officially started camp.
How is it different than what you're used to? It's usually your dad, right?
He took me in my comfort zone. You know, being back at home, you know, I was really doing things on my own, you know. Even though my dad was training me, I was pretty much dictating everything, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I needed to get out of my comfort zone, you know what I mean?
Hey, Kevin doesn't mess around.
Yeah, Kevin don't mess around.
My dad don't either.
My dad don't either. You know, but I got my dad's soft spot. I could tell him.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah. This time, you know, I had somebody else telling me what to do and what not, you know what I'm saying? So like I said, it took me out of my comfort zone.
But is this the most?
What's up, man?
Hey, what's going on?
Would you say this was the most heated face-off you've had at a weigh-in?
Yeah.
Because usually you're very chill.
Come on, Brendan.
What's up, Dad?
With him, Brendan. Brendan, come here.
What's going on, man? TBT.
It's Friday.
He know what it is.
You run your open?
Hell yeah.
Coach, how was the weigh-in for you?
Perfect. Excellent.
Why? Got heated? Mm-hmm. That's normal, right?
It's all good. Money ripped and ready. I can't say that for Mikey, though.
Why?
I ain't see no muscle nowhere in his stomach. This boy got an 8-pack.
Adrian Broner told me right now that your training camp, quote, a 5-star jail.
Nah,
he meant it in a good way. Like, it's so isolated from the world. You're focused.
Yeah.
You're not going anywhere. You're not partying. But it's business. But it's a great condition and great boxing.
Yeah, we produce mean, lean fighting machines.
So what's the routine for the next 24 hours between now and fight night?
You're ready to go eat real good and just chill and relax, man. The work is done.
Hey. Ooh, the hottest.
Robert, last question. So what are you going to eat now? Now you can eat, you can gain your weight back?
You know what? I was eating since last night, you know?
Really?
I was eating since last night. I was on weight, you know what I mean? Now I'm just about to...
you know, we got the second weigh in the morning, so I can't
only 10 pounds. Yeah, you can.
So, you know, but I'm about to go eat good, real good. I got some salmon upstairs. I got some ice cream too. Don't tell nobody. Chocolate. Don't tell nobody. But you know, I'm still eat good. You know what I mean?
Tell all the fans where to follow you on Twitter and Instagram.
Follow me
and Snapchat.
Y'all can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, at @RobertEaster_Jr. Follow me on Snapchat at DabDaddy91. DabDaddy91.
By the way,
I promise you, I'm leaving that ring tomorrow with two straps, man. Listen to me. If you betting on me, bet the house. You're going to be a millionaire tomorrow.
There you have it, Robert Easter Jr. Thanks, Robert.
And I'm he leaving with two straps, and I'm leaving with two bitches with me about to have a freak show.
FanyasNewsReporting.com, Elie Seckbach reporting.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FanyasNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.